this will be a short video introducing the concept of time value of money. So let's first talk about what the time value of money really is. It's basically when you invest money, you expect to earn income over time. And that is the value of money over time. And there are three parts to the time value of money concept. The first one being the principal. This is typically denoted by a small p, and it represents the amount of the investment, or it can be the amount borrowed. So it could be money that you have invested in another company, that's the principal amount invested, or it could be the principal amount that you have borrowed. There are two types of principals. There can be a lump sum or single sum, and an annuity. A lump sum is an amount that you've invested or amount that you've borrowed one time, and it accumulates money over time or accumulates interest over time. An annuity would be money you've invested and then you invest more. And it's annuity has to be the exact same payments every time. So if it's a monthly thing or a yearly thing, it's the same amount each time. The next thing would be number of periods. This is the length of time from the beginning of the investment or the borrowing period to the end of the investment or the borrowing period. And the third component of the time value of money concept is interest rate. This is the annual percentage that is earned on the investment. Now notice the word annual. Interest rates are typically given on an annual basis. And we'll talk more about compounding later, but just keep in mind that when you're told an interest rate, it typically means that's a yearly interest rate. And there's two types of interest rates. There's simple interest, which is interest that's earned only on the principal, and then there's compound interest. Compound interest is interest earned not only on the principal, but you also are earning interest on the interest that you've already earned. So knowing these three pieces of time value of money, let's talk about a couple of concepts underneath the time value of money concept, and that's present value and future value. So for example, if I ask the question, if I invest a certain amount today, what would I have in the future? So another way to word that would be, how much would an investor be willing to invest today for a certain amount in the future? So although there's no numbers in this question, you really know what you're going to invest today. So if I invest a certain amount today, $10,000, $20,000, what will I have in the future? 10 years from now, 15 years from now. So really this is a future value question because I don't know what I will have in the future and that's what I'm looking for. What will I have sometime in the future? Now this becomes important when we start using our time value of money tables, because we need to know which table do we look at to find the answer to our question. So let's look at this timeline. We have the present value, which is today, and we have six time periods, and we have our future value. So if I were to say, and put this information on our timeline, if I were to invest $1,000 today at 10% annual interest, what would I have 6 years from now? Notice the question mark. It's under the future value. That means this is a future value question. Now, if we reverse that and say, well, if I want to have $2,400 6 years from now, what would I have to invest today? Notice where the question mark is. It's under present value. So this becomes a present value question. And again, not only do we have to know, are we going to use the present value or future value tables, we have to go back to this idea of, is it a lump sum or is it an annuity? In this particular scenario, this is a lump sum or single sum because it's a one-time investment of $1,000 in the beginning, or if I want $2,400 in the future, what would I have to invest today? That's a one-time payment. That's a lump sum. If I were to ask, well, if I want $2,400 6 years from now, how much would I have to invest each year over 6 years? That would be in an annuity.